Tēnā koutou katoa, welcome to the show. Now, recycling, we all know we're supposed to do it, but doing it has become increasingly complicated.
That's right. So if we do make the effort, we want to know it's going to the right place.
And because councils are using your money to pay for recycling, we decided to find out if they're doing the job right or doing the job at all. Here's Jill.
Prepare to be shocked as we find out where your public recycling goes.
I'm going to be pessimistic and say I don't think those things end up going to recycling at all.
We get councils to front up.
So these bins are pretty pointless, really.
About why some say our recycling is rubbish.
And we're so behind the rest of the world, it's going to get increasingly awkward.
And we find out what we have to do to stop landfills taking over.
There is a big job to be done and everyone is working on it.
Lunch on the go, it's a time saver but can be a resource waster. Still, some councils provide public bins for all that recyclable packaging.
Do I think it's a good idea?
Yeah.
Yeah, I do.
It gives people the option, but obviously you should recycle.
Some of the first public place recycling bins were funded in 12 cities by a grant linked to the 2011 Rugby World Cup. Now, 40 district or city councils tell us they offer this choice. Auckland Council says it collects recycling in clear plastic bags so it can check to see what to recycle. In contrast, litter bags are blue, but we found some recycling bins had blue bags too. The council says it's a mistake, but we saw it in January and again in March. So we thought we'd work with Consumer to try to find out where our public recycling really goes.
So this is a GPS tracker. It will give us the location as it moves around the country.
With trackers trapped inside.
No, this will be a first.
We send the cans undercover across Aotearoa into public recycling in Auckland, Taupō and Dunedin. We don't want them in landfill because it's already growing way too fast.
So under my feet, there are about 40 metres of compacted waste. And this is just Nelson and Tasman. There are landfill sites like this all over the country. It's decomposing, it's producing methane, and that all adds to global heating.
We're already sending 76% of our waste to be buried. We don't need our public recycling going there too. So what did we find? Let's start with Tamaki Makaurau, Auckland. It went to Dairy Flat, home to the Redvale landfill site. But the battery was tracked to an e-waste recycler. In Dunedin, which says about 15% of recycling gets dumped, the can signals strangely stop just short of the local landfill and recycling site. While the Taupō can appears smack bang in the middle of the area's main landfill. So inconclusive, but it prompted us to ask all councils, what is going on? And the answer was even more of a shock.
So how much of this public recycling actually ends up in landfill?
A massive quantity.
Yes, a shocking 100% of public recycling in Auckland is dumped. It's 100% for these four councils too. And at least 80% for all of these. Off to landfill, not sorted, just dumped. It begs the question, why even have the bins? Auckland Council says,
pretty much at the moment as an education aspect to actually prompt people that you do have recyclables that you might be using.
Really, for education? How does that go down?
That makes no sense at all, right?
That's pretty bad, I think.
It's shocking. And this is the truth, is it? Right, so why do we do it?
In Nelson 2, the council admits to the same problem with public recycling.
Unless it really looked worth sorting, the odds are it would be disposed of.
But stresses that councils aren't to blame.
In a nutshell, people just haven't been using them properly.
Which is true. We're really not sure what goes where.
I don't actually know. Was it the cup that you put in there?
Yeah.
So did you know that
it actually can't go into recycling?
Oh, I wasn't aware of that. That's a news. Okay, I need to be educated on that one.
And an impromptu test, recycling on the right, rubbish on the left, confirms our confusion.
Coffee cups. Straws can't. No.
No.
Soft plastic, rubbish.
Oh, jokes. Other way.
No. Shredded paper can't.
Oh, that's ridiculous.
That all leads to contamination, and with nowhere to wash things.
Can you recycle it if it's dirty?
It's contaminated with food too.
And then the next thing you know, you've got a whole bin that can't be recycled because it's got something that's made of plastic and paper, and that's got lots of coffee over everything.
But before we go blaming ourselves,
I'd say recycling for the everyday consumer is hard and confusing.
This waste expert says the fault is shared with manufacturers. Take our most common packaging material.
Plastic is a complex one. There are 7 types of plastics, and there's only really 3 of those types that we'd call recyclable plastics.
What about this one?
Wrong plastic type and the colour. Also, it has the lid on.
Most lids can't be recycled, and plastic types 3, 4, 6 and 7 generally can't. So we're supposed to remember the numbers and spot them?
There's a little symbol on the base of all plastics.
He thinks clearer, simpler labelling would really help.
You know, a simple tick box even that says, yes, it's recycling.
And we need consistency across the country.
So if they're doing recycling in Papamoa, they're doing their same recycling in Whanganui, for example. Same thing as going the same bins in the same ways.
Which brings us back to taupo and the can found in landfill. The council says maybe it was missed as it claims to have a high recycling rate and low contamination.
We achieve this by placing our recycling bins next to our big belly waste compactors. We work hard on our education program, and our recycling bins have got small orifices so that those larger contaminants are kept out.
But there's another problem every council faces, the cost. Look at these comparisons. On the left, cost per tonne of home recycling. On the right, from public bins. A huge jump because it needs so much more sorting due to such high contamination. A zero waste advocate says mixed recycling bins are a waste.
It's not working as well as it could because it's costing councils an enormous amount of money relative to the actual problem that they're solving.
So some councils like Hutt City and Marlborough have canned them. Some like Queenstown Lakes have switched to bins for specific items like this. Others like Nelson are replacing with bins just for rubbish, but big. While a few like Taupo are holding out. So if they're still standing by their bins, we think ratepayers will want to know why.
We don't think it's all about the cost. We really want to give our community the ability to do the right thing and recycle. This is a tourist destination. They expect to be able to recycle when they come here.
Whatever their current bin action, all councils agree there has to be change and it has to come from the top.
We need to bring in schemes like the container return scheme, which actually incentivizes people to take that container clean to a drop-off point.
Our advocate for zero waste loves the idea.
Buy the drink, you pay a little deposit, like 20 cents, that you get back when you bring your container to the appropriate place for recycling. This has been shown everywhere that has it. It increases the recovery rates to, you know, up to 90, 95%, and you have clean, high-quality material that can be recycled really effectively.
And she'd love the idea even more if manufacturers bore the cost too.
The beverage producer-facing fee of a few cents that covers the costs of the actual recycling part.
And everywhere there's consensus that education is key.
That is rubbish and that is compost.
Like at this Nelson City event.
The more people see good recycling, good waste avoidance and minimisation in practice, the more they come to expect it.
How are you?
And some councils also give grants to help companies reduce packaging, like selling juice in BYO bottles.
And how necessary do you think this kind of thing is?
I think it's incredibly necessary. We have a waste crisis, and single-use plastic and waste is a huge contributor of that.
Recycling needs a big shake-up, or council money, like so much packaging, will be going to waste.
Poor.
I don't know if I should be feeling sad or disappointed. I can't quite believe those numbers. We're obviously pretty good at home recycling, so that is good. The products, I guess, are easier to recycle, maybe we know more, but the stuff that is happening out in the public, that is not good at all.